Welcome to November. So since this is the month of Thanksgiving, we are going to do a gratitude type of focus reading. So number one, what are the general blessings that we're harvesting this month? Number two, what do I need to be grateful for in regards to health, career, finances, relationships? And then further from relationships, like how can I better express gratitude to others in my life? We're going to look at what we should be thankful for in our love relationships, or, you know, on our journey to finding those. And then how do I better express, you know, gratitude there as well? Looking at our spiritual and personal development path, what are the areas of thanks that we should be giving there? And then how do I better express gratitude to myself? Because, you know, hashtag self-care. So this is going to be a longer reading than usual for November, but let's get started. Aries, what is it that you have to be thankful for in the month of November? And they're saying this is a no drama month. This is also the kind of month where you can manifest whatever it is you want into your reality. So focusing on the things that you desire for your life is really, really important. It doesn't indicate that there's really much work you have to do in co-creating that. It's just like what we think about, we bring about. Opportunities present themselves in front of us to get what we want as long as we know what we want. So that's important. What should you be grateful for in regards to your health? And they say, you already know. So I guess that might be variable for everybody. In regards to your career, again, you already know. But in regards to career, they're also saying that this is about honesty in career. And they're saying some of you are forced with two options, and we've got to look at this through a different lens. You know, it's, if I go this way, what's going to happen versus this way? And they say, we want you to shift your perspective. Maybe it's not an either or, maybe it's a this and. So it would be easier to kind of suss that out in a personal reading, but generally they're saying, wherever you feel most confident, whatever is going to cater most to your strengths and inherent talents and abilities is the path that you want to take. Now, what should you be thankful for in regards to your finances? And they say the challenge is to be patient, to kind of chill, to kind of rest. And so that might be chilling and resting in regards to your spending, or maybe not trading certain stocks or bonds that you've purchased and just waiting to see how those shift and change. They're saying something's happening in a non-traditional kind of way for you, in a way that is unexpected, and it can be to your benefit, but it reminds you to stay calm and just chill. In regards to your relationships, what should you be thankful for? And I'm talking about the relationships that are non-romantic. And they're saying those are stable, those are happy, they're content. Any changes that are coming are positive there, and really focusing on the longer term, like kind of forever friendships that you have, as opposed to acquiring new friends. Some friends you've had your entire life, and they will continue to be there for you through the ups and downs, and it's important that we express gratitude to them. So how should you do that? And they're saying, just letting them know that you feel lucky and that your life is enhanced by having them in your life. Now, as far as romantic relationships go, if you're single, what they're saying is being single right now is exactly where you're supposed to be, because you're in the process of healing some things. And so you should be grateful that you're not fucking up a new relationship by not being ready for that. And that makes a lot of sense in a Mercury retrograde when we're kind of forced to look at our past so we can clear things away. They say if you've already done that, or if you do that in the month of November, new love could be coming your way. But if you haven't, it's a necessary thing to do. And you have to be really honest with yourself about what you're holding on to and what's working for you and what isn't. Now, for those of you who are coupled, they say be thankful that your partner communicates with you in great detail. Whether that's a really detailed and explicit kind of sexy text message. I don't know how you would say that. Sexy text message? A sext? of exactly what it is that they want to do. And that could be exciting for you when you get home. Or whether it's that they specifically build you up with certain character traits that you have. Like, I love this thing about you. It makes you feel really good. That's something to be appreciative of. And so how do you say thank you for that? And they say, don't do it immediately, because it's not going to feel as genuine. If you wait a couple days and you say, hey, remember when you said this thing? That really made me feel, you know, special, because that would be really great. Because the thing is if you say it right away, then it's not as genuine. They're like, oh, you're just saying that because that's like the right thing to do and that's what you always do. But it makes you feel, because you're a very strong fire sign, it's going to make you seem more sentimental and emotional. I'm not saying you don't have feelings and emotions, but coming across to your partner, if you wait a couple days and you say, hey, you know, a few days ago when you said this thing, it really made me feel like this. That's going to make them feel really, really special and like they're doing a great job in really boosting up your ego and making you feel good in the relationship. So let's see what else. As far as your spiritual life, your personal development or your spirituality goes, what should you be thankful for this month? And they're saying that we're moving on from something that maybe used to serve us really well, that we have a lot of love and nostalgia for, towards something better. So, for example, maybe you grew up in a Catholic household and you're like, you know what, Catholicism is really special to me, but I don't know that it's for me anymore. And you take a different path. You can still carry some of those traditions and love that faith, but move on to something that works better for you. Or, for example, in your spiritual development, you could say, you know what, I spent a lot of time doing meditation or doing yoga, but now I'm going to expand. They're saying this is going to help you a lot to deal with a lot of the kind of stuck emotions that we have that we've been stuffing and haven't brought to the surface. And if we don't bring those to the surface, they're going to erupt and blow over and kind of hurt ourselves, the people around us. They're saying you don't have full control over your emotions right now in the month of November. And that makes sense with a Mercury retrograde. So what they're saying is this is going to help you exert better control over that. So how do you do better self-care and really appreciate and express gratitude to your own self? And what they're saying is it's not by spending money on yourself. It's not by buying yourself something new, a car that you wanted, a new handbag, getting your nails done, getting a massage. It's nothing like that. What they're saying is like you honor yourself by identifying what your feelings truly are and kind of feeling them, whether they're negative or positive. Because even if they're negative, if we kind of acknowledge like, oh, that hurts my heart, you put your hands on your heart, you're like, okay, I feel that. And then you can release it, okay? And that's going to give you better balance in your life. This month for you is all about achieving balance. And then once you find it, seeing how your life moves forward in a better direction for you, it's sort of a new beginning that puts you on a more destined and sort of quote-unquote holy path, like towards what it is that you're supposed to be doing in this lifetime. What they're saying is some of you have been avoidant of what it is that truly sparks your interest, sparks your passions. And if you need help with that, like the angels are your spirit guides, they're there to help you out at any point in time should you just ask. It's seriously as simple as, can you help me with this? Just closing your eyes and asking, and poof, there they are. So that's November. I'll see you in December.